and welcome to our special Thursday nights that we're doing on Saturday, Big Brother 17 show, where we're connecting you guys with your favorite Big Brother players. Of course, you guys know if you're watching on YouTube, you can click on these buttons, thumbs up and subscribe, that helps support our shows. If you're listening or watching in iTunes, 5-star rating and a nice review is awesome too. Lastly, become a patron. If you want to support our shows, yourrealityrecaps.com/patron. You get access to the Facebook group only for patrons and shows only for patrons. So that's awesome. And lastly, tweet us your questions for Johnny Mac and Becky, or you can leave them in the chat room. But if you tweet us them, I'll pull them up on the screen. Hashtag YRRLive. Have that in your tweet. And lastly, since you're here, become a fan. That's awesome too. And as soon as I bring your two faves on and shrink my little head down, tweet it out. Square, megaphone, up arrow. Let everyone know we're on with Johnny Mac and Becky. So, with that said, oh my God, here's your faves. It's Johnny Mac and Becky! Yay! Hi, guys. How are you guys doing?
Wonderful.
Awesome. How are you doing?
I'm full. You know, Thanksgiving and all.
Oh,
that's expected after, Are the leftovers done yet?
Yeah, well, I sent it home with everybody. I sent all those leftovers home.
Smart.
That's smart. Get it off your hands.
Seriously, who?
I eat all the leftovers.
See, I don't like eating it off the. It's like a I had to cook it, and it was very clearly an animal in my sink that I was washing. It grossed me out. No, didn't like it.
But you can make like turkey sandwiches the day after, and pumpkin pie. It's my favorite. You can always have that later.
Yeah.
Well, let's start with this. Becky, what did you do for Thanksgiving?
I went to my sister's house, and so I have a lot of sisters. And then my parents went back to St. Louis. So we do an all-girls sister Thanksgiving. Mm-hmm. And then, just cook, hang out with the nieces, and it's a lot of women.
A lot of women. Okay, Johnny Mac, were you around a lot of women or no on your Thanksgiving?
No, absolutely not. I'm just here with my family. My brother is a dude and not a girl, so he doesn't
count. He has better hair than me, though.
Yeah, he's got long flowing locks.
Interesting. So had dinner with him on Thanksgiving?
My brother and my parents, yes.
Now, Johnny Mac, I have a theory.
And what's that?
I need you to confirm or deny. I think some of these Thanksgiving foods have been created by dentists in order to get more work. Like the pecan pie. That's always very sticky. It will dislodge a filling. I think it was created by a dentist.
It could have been. You never know. I mean, we got access to all kinds of crazy baking strategies that most people aren't aware of. So... yeah, it definitely could have been. So you got to watch yourself there.
That is what I'm thinking.
Dentist conspiracy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Dentist conspiracy indeed. Okay. I'm sure you're aware what the number one question, we need to get it out of the way right now.
What's my favorite color?
What is your
Green.
Favorite color? No. Everybody wants to know what the status of the your guys' relationship is these days.
Same thing we always say.
Yeah.
Same thing you always say. Okay.
Are you talking about hashtag Jackie?
Yeah, we're talking about hashtag Jackie. I mean, we know that you guys were together. Let me ask you this. I want an answer in less than a second. Has there been any kissing? You took too long. Nope, I'm not buying it anymore. Okay, but look. I appreciate
it. Ready? Oh, wait, I have to turn this way.
Okay, there you go.
Does kiss me out, please. Work?
Johnny Mac.
Wait, there we go.
Screen grab it, everybody. Screen grab it. There you go. You can say it happened here. A reality recaps first.
Yeah, I don't know how much making on YouTube, happens. And
No. So what was it like when you guys were together? Because you were just together last week. Was that, what things... I'm going to let you guys tell us. What did you two do while you were together?
Do you want my side of the story?
Yes. Fine. Johnny Mac, you go first.
So I'm heading out there. I get out of work early to get to my flight here in Scranton, and my flight's delayed here.
Mm-mm.
I got to the airport like 2 hours early. So they're like, I was going to get connected at Philly, which is like 2 hours south of here. So they're like, yeah, why don't you try to drive down there and make it? Otherwise, you're not going till tomorrow. So I was like, damn it. So I tried driving down there. I missed it by like 10 minutes. And I didn't get out there till the next day. But then I hung out with Becky's friend, Steve.
Because I was at work. So mind you, he's supposed to come the night before. We're supposed to hang out. And now he's coming while I'm at work. So go on.
Yeah, so Steve picks me up from the airport. We go to the New Belgium Brewery. It's a microbrewery place out there. And that was awesome. They had a slide, a twisty slide. There was a lot of different beers. They had a sour one that was pretty good.
Uh-huh.
Then after that, then we tried to drive up to Breckenridge. And I'll let her talk about that. She was driving.
Yeah, so John and I are trying to head up to Breckenridge. It's been a big plan that he's a skier. Mm-hmm. He's never skied in Colorado, so of course we have to go. There is a snowstorm that night, and the main highway is completely shut down. So we try to take a back highway, and it took 6 hours for a drive that's supposed to take 1 hour and 30 minutes.
Wow.
So 4 times the amount. We were stuck in the car for hours.
And no kissing? What did you do to pass the time?
Yeah, you're driving on ice, making out, it works.
Yeah, that's right. That's only something people do when they're teenagers. I remember that now. That's how I got into my car accident.
Kissing. I was saying, how many accidents did you get in?
I got into one accident, kissing and driving, and it was the first day I ever drove a car. So there you go, lesson learned. Oh.
Okay.
Kids, I hope you're watching.
Feeling confident on the first day.
I know, real, whatever. okay, so you guys are going and now it's mountains. So is it more like you were doing nature-y stuff or you said skiing, right? You were mm-hmm. doing skiing and that skiing, that was all? I'm not trying to trick you. I was just wondering if just skiing was what
all
you
did. Tell him, John, what we
No, we did. We did skiing. Had some good beers. We went down with her friends to a Mexican restaurant for some Mexican food. It was pretty good. And then there's a bar there called Ollie's that we went to. Ooh. And it was like kind of like a local ski bum bar, and it was awesome. Played Pac-Man. For a while.
Ashley 916 in the chat room, Becky says she remembers that weather all too well, and it's why she moved to Florida.
Yeah. Oh, no. But once you get to Breckenridge, if you've seen those photos, it is just, ask John, it's like a winter wonderland, like nothing beats it.
Yeah, it is cool.
I don't know how to ski. I went skiing one time and I thought my legs were going to snap. So that was, was it. I thought I was going to die. My legs are going to break. And I was like, okay, I'm done. I'm more of a lodge hot cocoa person.
No bunny.
Yeah. I'm a snob. I like to watch the people falling and laugh at them. That's probably why it's karma. That's what God did that to me.
John didn't get to go on this run, but on peak 7, so it was a peak over John that we were supposed to meet at, and uh-huh. it was close. Oh, yeah. There's a big hot tub at the bottom of the hill, and you can just hang out in like one of these 7 hot tubs and just watch everyone come down, whether they fall or make it.
Oh, I think I would
like. That's what the snow bunnies do.
Do they give you the little cards? Can you write like 9, 8? Can you like rate their fall? Oh, I'm sorry. It's 2015. It's on our iPad Pros. We just have the numbers.
We just tweet it to you.
Right. We'll just tweet it as you're falling. Becky, Parawolf in the chat room wants to know, how is your new job going? And for those that may not know, you're not with Abercrombie anymore, right?
Yeah, I started a new financial job, and technically I'm just an intern right now.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to go through your certifications. And as John, I've been a mental wreck right now because I just study for hours and hours and hours a day. And if I pass the test on December 10th, I get to keep my job. And if I don't, I get let go. And five girls in a row have failed. So we're hoping I'm going to be the first girl to pass the program in a year.
Okay. So everybody, if you pray, you have to pray for Becky. If you're a well-wisher, let's send her well wishes. If you're like into the occult, a pentagram and some sort of a spell, if that helps. Whatever they're into, Becky. Whatever. Whatever they want to do to make it happen for you. We're fine.
I need wishes.
Miss Voodoo.
Voodoo.
Miss Voodoo!
Bring back Miss Voodoo.
What that is?
What Miss Voodoo is?
Yes.
No, what? Oh, you're the tinfoil.
Yes.
Yeah.
Of course. Who has that, by the way?
No one has Miss Voodoo, but I have Larry, which, by the way, Miss Voodoo and Larry were on the block, and everybody voted out Larry.
I know, I do. I remember that. But wait, why? Somebody has to have it. You mean production just took it and threw it away?
We probably cleaned the house and threw it away. That was like several weeks left in the house. Production wasn't in the house. It was just us.
Okay, chat room. Everybody just pull out your headphones for a second. Just don't listen, chat room, for like 30 seconds and stop listening. Okay, listen.
Sorry.
No, both of you, you're listening. You need to go to your kitchens, make one of those damn things out of tinfoil. You put it on eBay, you sign it, and then you give the money away to charity. Okay, everybody put your headphones. Hey, everybody, they found it. Oh my God, it's so crazy. Yay. They found it in their luggage.
John has it.
There we go.
Oh, that's so gonna, stupid of me.
That we found it. They'll have to just give it to charity. So everyone in the chat room is like, we can hear you. Comedic recaps. Becky, I see a lot of people. I love waffles. KK Whitting. They want to know, how are things with you and Vanessa now? Are you guys?
Oh, they're great.
They're good?
I think. Yeah, and I think that was one of the funny things is that I actually really like Vanessa as an individual, which is why I was losing my mind while I was going after her, because on a personal level, I had nothing against her. She's not annoying to live with. Mm-hmm. Like, she is a great person. And so us coming back together and hanging out again, it didn't take much at all. Mm-hmm. So in Vegas, I was like, when we were at our house, she was so great. She like had us all over, threw a great party, bought us all alcohol and food the whole weekend. And I was like, can you hurry up and take a picture with me so people know I'm not after you? Like, she was a dangerous person in the game and I had to get rid of her. But doesn't mean you hate him at the end of the day.
I loved your tweet that, or I think you even said it in the house, that you survived Black Friday so you could handle Vanessa.
Yes.
All right. Now, Johnny Mac, we have to, now chat room. They want me to put you on the spot. I have to ask a tough question.
Uh-oh.
Who's going to win in a fight, Vanessa or Becky?
Vanessa. Sorry.
In a fight?
No. In a verbal.
Oh.
We don't condone violence here.
Yeah. If it was going to be physical, I'd say Becky, but...
Oh, that's good.
Verbally, it's probably going to be Vanessa.
Look.
I thought physically she could beat me up.
She's going to lawyer it, and she's going to win.
That could be true. Look, Becky, and believe me, Vanessa knows I love her, but I'm also working on a theory with her. If you ever end up in All Stars with her... Her power is in under that hat. I think she like steals people's souls and sticks
that
it. If you rip the hat off, I think you take her power source. It's just the theory I'm working on. So keep that in mind.
It's like Frosty the Snowman.
Exactly. Exactly.
Yeah, all right.
Speaking of All Stars, we're also floating a theory here that we think it will be next year. That's our opinion. And
it's next year.
What?
I said every year it's next year.
Yeah. and especially next, that's just our theory. It's all we're saying. It's not like we have proof or anything. So now we thought it would be fun to come up with ways that like what the twist could be. So one of the twists that we came up with was maybe playing in pairs. So you two can't pick each other, but you could pick anybody else from any other season. If you got to pick a person, now keep in mind, you're a pair playing as one. You don't get to play individual. Like, if one of you gets nominated, you both go out. So,
ooh.
who would you pick to play Big Brother All-Stars with?
Dang, that's a tough one.
John, you go first.
And it can be, I'll say it can be anybody you want. Yeah, I was going to limit it to your cast. You can limit it to your cast if that makes it easier for you to pick. You just can't pick each other.
Or we could do both.
Okay, or tell me both.
All right, if it's limited to our cast.
Right.
I'd have to go with Jason.
Really?
Yeah, I want to play with Jason.
I would not have expected you to say that. Why would you pick Jason?
Because I think he knew the game really well, and he was good at it. He just talked a lot at the beginning, and I think he'd know not to do that the second time around. Plus, he's hilarious.
Okay, now I'll give you time to think about your anybody. I'll go to Becky. Who would you pick from your season?
Oh, okay, I'm not just taking this answer. I think Jason would be a great person.
Okay.
Because the whole reason, like, this is thinking Big Brother. You start thinking, like, 10 steps ahead.
Right.
If you were to pick someone that went really far and go into the, like, All-Stars with them, people would get rid of that person really fast. You can't pick Steve. You can't pick Vanessa.
Right.
Because people eliminate them right away, and then there you go. But Jason, they'll underthink. However, he can win comps, and he knows the game.
He knows the game like rain.
But you have to put duct tape on his mouth.
Right. You would have to control him. He's freaky how you can be like, who was out sixth on Big Brother 5? And he'll be like, blah, blah, blah.
What was the carpet color in the HOH den on...
I don't know... I couldn't name three things they ate on Thanksgiving. I don't know how he does that. Okay, Johnny Mac, anybody from any season, who are you picking?
So I feel like if you ask me this question on a different day, it could change. But like the one that's coming into my head right now is Enzo. He's also hilarious.
All right, so you're going with, and this is why we like you, Johnny Mac. And yes, yeah. Chat room, everybody else is saying, God, we miss Johnny Mac's laugh. But, okay, so you're going for, you want to be in there with someone that you're going to have a good time with.
Yeah.
Okay, you're not making it far, Johnny Mac. Becky.
What?
Becky.
Bye.
We thought you learned the first time, Johnny Mac. Becky, who are you going with? You can okay. Go with anybody.
This is well thought out. I would take, for a complete game point, I would take Brendan, because Brendan got in trouble and sent home due to showmance reasons. However, separate him from a showmance, he didn't make it that far. Once again, going off the theory, if you put Derek back in the game, mm-hmm. who's my favorite player, Derek's going to get kicked out right away. Mm-hmm. It's Derek. Mm-hmm. Then again, Dan Giesling didn't right away, mm-hmm. so mm-hmm. who knows that theory? But I think if you take someone who can win a lot of comps, you know, and that doesn't have like a big background to them and didn't go that far in the game, once again, people underestimate them, but they'll win and take me further.
I love it. Brilliant. Now, Johnny Mac, I'm not here just to criticize your choice. I'm going to pair you with, this is who I think, if you ever get to pick Johnny Mac.
Okay.
You want a Frank Udy. You want
I thought about that. No, but people kick him out right away. Everyone knows Frank.
But Becky, to be fair, let's be real. If it's an All-Star season, there's gonna be Derek.
Frank.
Probably Vanessa. Probably Dan Giesling. Probably the person I was going to pair you with, Amanda.
I think definitely
Frankie. Sorry, chat room, but it's probably going to happen. They're all big. They're all the people that you would say that's who's going to go out first. I think when you have all the that's who you get out first playing, it's going to make it harder.
Yeah, so. If it was filled with people like that, like if Frank and Dan Giesling and Derek and Vanessa are all in the house, you change your strategy.
Mm-hmm.
Because they're all number one choices.
They are. They're all first out. What?
That would make these interviews interesting. People would be like, well, why didn't you get Derek out that week? It was like, because... because you had to get Dan out that week.
Exactly.
Someone had to go.
I do not envy either of you. And I'll just say, the Olympics are next summer. CBS is going to need something really good on TV to compete with that. And I just think it has to be All-Stars.
Yeah, they did Coach.
You what?
They did Coach's season during. No, I don't know. Yeah, it was Coach's season.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And it was so weird on your season how, like, it started out with twist after twisted, twistity twist. And then the Olympics got announced, and it was like CBS just reined all their money in. It was like, what are you guys holding all your money for? Why'd you stop all the twists? You're saving it for next year? Because you got a 2-year contract, and maybe next year we're All-Stars? Maybe, in my opinion, speaking on behalf of myself, it's going to be All-Stars. So, that being said, I hope to see both of you playing it again. Becky, I want you to go in there, and I want drunk Becky back. I would like drunk Becky back. And Johnny Mac, you were perfect. I just want you to be a little more cutthroat. A little more cutthroat. You're brilliant strategically. Oh, and you have to talk to us more, Johnny Mac.
Yeah, on the live feeds?
Yes, that is... That, if I would say the one negative questions I'm getting a lot for you are all people that are like, Johnny Mac, why didn't you talk to us more? You're a fan of the show. You should have talked to us more.
Yeah, I'll if I ever get back in there, I'll do it. But when I watch the feeds, I guess I never saw anyone doing that. Like, it was usually like conversations or like, maybe it was more, I'd only watch when there were conversations going on, so I had no idea any of that.
Yeah.
Right.
Or like, how do I just talk to the camera here?
There were so many times I thought doing that, but it feels so weird while you're in the house. You're like, do I just start talking? And like, the walls are paper thin. Mm-hmm. And so you're like, are they going to realize what I'm doing on the outside? Like, it's also strategy too. Because there's times I wanted to be like, this is what I'm really freaking doing and thinking right now.
Yes, but that's what we want.
Yes, but they can hear it outside.
You can whisper. You can just, let me tell you, on so many psychological levels, you should know that wins you America's Favorite Player, because the whole voting audience feels this whole other relationship with you, because more than what's edited from what you're saying in the diary room, we're really getting your unfiltered thought, and then they feel more connected to you. So like in all the years of covering Big Brother, I feel like the people who have had those conversations with the feeders are, they seem to get a lot of advantages in the game. Let's put it that way.
No, but it makes sense, because there's so many things that I thought and was doing. I was playing hard and people thought I wasn't playing. Mm-hmm. But I had these like obnoxiously elaborate plots and they just didn't make DR. Like, it wasn't a showman. So it was like, well, that's not the show. Like, there's a showman.
And that's another thing. Because here's another theory that a lot of people are throwing out. There is enough people to do a couple's season. So there are enough Big Brother real life couples now, or even ex-couples, to turn it into a couple's season. So maybe you two would end up playing together. Even, I mean, we're just saying, I'm not saying you are, I'm just saying people put you two together as a couple and they can't help. So if that happens, then you might have to play that up for the camera, but play it off.
Against Hayden and Nicole? Sorry, that's just another thought.
I don't like them. I'm allowed to say it now. I'm not a Hayden and Nicole fan. I'm sorry.
Your show, your thoughts.
Yeah. Meet them in person. Yeah, whatever. That's all I'll say. Anyway, they're super friendly if it was opposite day. Anyway. But good luck to them. Good luck. Hi, have fun. Okay. Let me say this. I think that if you two play together, you would be a force to reckon with. I think if you got to play with the people that you want to play with, that would be very interesting to watch. And the only other thing that I'll comment is, Becky, I don't know if you would survive being paired with Brendan. I don't know if Rachel could handle that.
I don't want the aftermath. I'm purely picking Brendan because he can win comps for me. And
Rachel would climb the wall, Becky.
She would.
She would and throw with the that baby.
She's going to have the baby by the...
Oh, no, no, no. The baby is... The rope will be attached to the baby and she'll fling it over the wall and she'll repel... And she'll be like, nobody gets the baby by me, Becky! Oh, that would be crazy. Don't
I'm
do that.
Huge Rachel and Brendan fans.
Who is it?
Adore them.
Oh, they are the... I still say I want a toddler edition. Again, we also have enough kids. We got an Adam Pock kid. We got a new Derek kids. We got Brendan and Rachel kid. So many kids. We need a toddler edition.
Yeah, you can't lock me in the house for that long with children. I'm sorry. I dealt with the Nolan twins for long enough screaming. I don't want children.
Oh, okay. Well, now, since you brought it up, Becky, how are you feeling about the Nolan twins?
No, honestly, like, they're cool girls. Living with them was really hard because if you watch the live feeds, they scream a lot. Mm-hmm. All the time.
So we just don't like the screaming.
So I just didn't like the screaming. I couldn't deal it. But at the same time, you get screaming, but they clean a lot. So you come out, they might be screaming in the kitchen, but you come out and the kitchen's clean. So yeah. I guess it's one for one.
I love it.
They were very good at keeping everything spotless.
Yes. So, you know, maybe I deal with the screaming and keep them.
And they were good at being scared. And they were good at cooking. And I mm-hmm. think Liz, mm-hmm. I think they did have good game. I think they definitely had good Big Brother games, you know, at points. Yes. Well, whatever. We don't want to argue the what Vanessa controlled and didn't control. But okay. Yeah. Let us say, since we're talking about game for a minute, Saba N in the chat room wants to know, Becky, would you have done anything differently now looking back on your game? Like, is there anything you wish you did different?
You know, you can always wish you do something different because as a viewer, you watch and you're like, I know exactly what they should have done to win it. I knew what they should have said and what they should have X, Y, and Z. Mm-hmm. Reality is, can you withstand that mental state on day 60 to deliver what needs to be done? And I think that's kind of where I broke down was I am... the nicest person. I don't argue with anyone on a daily basis. And going after Vanessa, who I had so much respect for, tore me apart. So I might not be the best Big Brother player. So it's like, I wanted her out. Sorry, this is a long explanation.
No, that's
but
fine.
Yeah,
they
like,
want to hear you. They want to hear what you think.
It was a huge mental, like, I realized when she stayed in the house after, like, I put her up on the block, she stays in the house. And all I knew is that I'd be going home next unless I really throw her under the bus. And same thing. Then I got put next to John on the block. And if I would have thrown John, like, I could have dragged John under the bus and might have made it a little longer in the game. Mm-hmm. And I couldn't, you know, it's just aww. As a person, I couldn't do it. But I didn't. Everything. I wanted to stay in the house so bad. And I wanted to tell them all the reasons why to keep me, mm-hmm. but not the reasons why to send John home right. and why he was a bad person. Mm-hmm. And at the end of the day, push came to shove, and I couldn't throw Vanessa down hard enough, and I couldn't drag John under the bus. So I went home.
I feel so bad for you, Johnny Mac, because they just keep giving me the hard questions to ask you. Anyway, okay. Here it is, Johnny Mac. You know, when we were watching, we couldn't help but notice that Clay fell on the sword for Shelly. And people want to know, why weren't you willing to go out for Becky?
Because I don't think we were in a showmance.
That's a good answer.
We were there to play, both of us. So it was just like, it's almost the same thing. When I was up against Steve, I think him and I campaigned a lot harder against each other than like, us two did here, but I think we were both there to play a game, not pull a Clay.
Right.
You know? So that's what it was.
All right. Here's a serious question, Johnny Mac. It's from Lovely Waffles. And again, I don't know why they're putting this through. But anyway, wants to know, John, do you like waffles?
I mean, they're okay.
They're okay. There you go.
I don't own a waffle iron.
Don't get
they're
one.
Lots of clean.
What'd you say, Becky?
They're lots of clean.
Oh my God, I wish this was on speaker. It is so point. Why can't they make one where you take the grills out and can actually wash them? Why is it connected so that you have to wipe it out with a paper towel and put it away? Who wants disgusting last time's waffle when you're making the new waffle?
You just do pancakes. You can wash it easier, right. same mix, and the butter is easier to spread.
I completely agree, but somebody else around here is like, no, you need waffles.
But we're not hating on your waffles, because if you make me waffles, I'll eat them any day. I just don't want to make them.
I'm getting a little waffle touchy at the moment.
Don't get waffled.
Hello, Hannah 6 wants to know, I think we've asked you this both separately, but now I want to see it together. Would both of you do Amazing Race together?
Sure. I don't know. Yeah. I'd probably lose at that one. I don't really watch the show a whole lot. I've only watched like 2 or 3 seasons of it. And the part where they get stuck in the airport, like, I know that's exactly where I'd lose it.
No, but I would do good at that. Like, I've traveled all around Europe. I drive stick shift. God knows you don't. But you're better at like competition stuff as long as you get, you know, you can do more of the endurance stuff. You lasted longer on the edge.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we might do all right.
I think you honestly, and I'm being completely serious, I think out of all the people, and I'm thinking through, yes, all the people from your cast, I do have to say, I think you two would be the best on Amazing Race, like athletic wise, like intelligence wise. I just think you two would be really good on the Amazing Race. And Johnny Mac, people would love you in other countries. You could just laugh and they'd be like, they would love it.
They would instantly understand everything I'm thinking and be like, yes, go here.
They would. And I'm telling you, in case, because you would never be allowed to confirm or deny, you would just pop up on Amazing Race. So I'm just telling you, if that ever happens, flashcards. You're allowed to bring stuff with you. You draw an airplane, you draw a car, because in other countries, you don't need to know the language. You can just show them the card. Like, I need to go to the airport and show them the airport. So you make flashcards. You're allowed to. That's a tip from people that have won the game.
Okay.
There you go.
John, we would win that.
Inside info here. Yeah.
We need to go on. Can everybody write CBS right now?
Yeah. Tweet at, oh boy, at Amazing Race _ CBS. Somebody in the chat room will say it. Whoever is in the chat room, and I'm sure you guys will know what the Amazing Race Twitter is, but put it in the chat room for everybody. There's like hundreds and hundreds of you in there. Go tweet them and say, Johnny Mac and Becky for the next Survivor. I'll let you in on a secret, though.
What's up?
How do I want to put this and not get any of us in trouble? Okay, so allegedly, they don't like to let Big Brother people win. So, like, when Big Brother people play, allegedly, maybe I've heard a story that's probably not true, they might put things in your way or manipulate situations to make sure you don't win. But trust me, you'll get to the final three because they're going to bank on all your fans watching from Big Brother.
But I don't know. Phil and I, we're like this now. We spent a whole 30 seconds in the Big Brother living room together and he was over a teleprompter. So
me too.
Yeah.
We're like this too.
Yeah. I'll just say, everyone knows it. It's social media season. Like, they're all racing right now and it's this social media edition and they're like showing us parts of the races and stuff on Facebook. We talked about it a little and you guys can, not you guys, the viewing audience, unless you want to, go ahead and watch it. John and I, the person I do reality recap Cabs with, they asked us to be on this season. And I was like, that's really funny. That's never. You couldn't pay me enough money. Because again, there's things that I allegedly might apparently allegedly know that would allegedly make me never do that show allegedly. Whoa. I think I covered myself legally. Anyway, you know, it's all demographics. Anywho, winners. Becky, did you keep the cat coffee mug that you always used? Kelly Campwell wants to know.
Yeah. Okay. Funny thing about that mug.
Okay.
I have it. Okay. So they gave me that mug, and the first time I went to go use it, part of the porcelain, like it's a cheap mug, and so it's like stained brown on the inside from the first time I used coffee. And so I didn't actually want it. So when I got evicted, I left it in the house and they mailed it to me. So it's back again.
Now they mailed it to you with your original box or they mailed you a second box?
You know that box that they said with like your Trainiac or my Trainiac picture? Right. And Larry came in it. Yeah, the cup showed up. So I put it in the like kitchen cabinet with my roommates. So if my roommates use it, but it's not my go-to.
Interesting.
In the house, it's nice because they very purposely do not, they make all the glasses the same.
Uh-huh.
And you don't have like a marker to label it. And this causes you to forget what cup is yours, to always get out more. And then it causes fights because there's not a dishwasher. Ask John. Like cups end up anywhere because you can never find your own with 16 people using the same color cup.
Yeah. And it gets down to 10 people. And then there's like, there's too many dishes for us here. Like everyone just takes them and doesn't wash them. So it's just like, we don't need all this stuff.
Steve. You wanted to say Steve there. I heard a very interesting fact. You two should not confirm or deny this because I don't know if you'll get in trouble. So neither of you confirm or deny. But I always mean to tell this to Big Brother fans. I heard something, a rumor that cups are labeled a certain way in case people are sick or have a specific sickness that you don't want to drink from that, like they have to be labeled because you wouldn't want to get something that somebody else has. I don't know.
We never had a sick person on our entire season. Right. No one once got sick. So we wouldn't actually know.
Okay. I was.
Huh, John? Because like other than Steve got his like canker sore in his tongue one time, that was.
There we go. Let's say canker sores. Yeah. If somebody's ever had a canker sore, their cup has to be labeled so that you know that person's had a canker. That's just what I don't really know if it's true or not. But I don't know if you two are allowed to talk.
The one thing I think we can talk about, which is not an issue, when so we don't see anyone, but if they ever have to like put something in the house for us, there's a tape with our name on it. So that might be a squirrel costume and it's labeled Becky with tape. And so you save, we learn at first we throw that tape away and then we learn that's the one thing we have with our name on it. So if you put that on a cup, that's your cup. Or you put that on a drawer, it's your drawer, your makeup bag, et cetera, et cetera. So we started to use those a lot.
Interesting. Okay. Let me ask you both this question from Hellari Dally B, who wants to know, have you guys had any funny fan experiences? And I'll just follow to tack that on to the end. A lot of people in chat room want to know if you guys have any meet and greets planned. So first, any funny fan experiences from both of you?
For me, it's cool at work when it happens. It's just like, not everyone has watched the show in Scranton, but like, I'd say at least like a fifth of the people that come in the office have seen me on it. So it's cool going and seeing a new patient. I'm just doing my regular thing. And then we're done. They're like, I love you on the show. I'm like, you watched it. I get to like slip out of doctor mode and into like, okay, I could just relax for a minute here. talk about it.
I couldn't imagine what that would be like at all. Like to be doing a job that is as serious as working in somebody's mouth and having that person be like, I got your Tyac, I got your Tyac. You're like,
We make it work. It works out pretty well, actually. It's just like, yeah, we get the joking done. And it's like, okay, you got, can't be talking while I'm doing this or someone's going to get hurt. It's not going to be me.
Right. Because Johnny Mac, what if they're in the chair and you're starting to drill and they're like, Steve, shut up. Steve, what? How awesome is that?
So how do you feel about Vanessa?
Yeah, I'm going to be like, drill's going to go in the places it shouldn't go if you keep moving.
Team Vanessa, Team Steve. Keep drilling.
Yeah. Okay, I have a really funny story, though.
Okay, go ahead, Becky.
This is hysterical. I was at my sister's house in Parker the day before Thanksgiving. We were making pumpkin pies the night before, and it's dark out, and FedEx dropped a package off. And I answered the door, got the package, and it said for Dennis. And I looked at her. I was like, Dennis, who's that? She's like, new people next door. They just moved in. So I walk over to the house and I take this package at night. It's dark outside. Ring the doorbell. And she looks through the blinds. She looks at me, closes it. And then it stays dark for a while. So I'm just sitting on the porch and nobody started opening up the door. She opens it and just stares at me. And I was like, hi, you know, I'm Stephanie's sister next door. Got this package. It's for Dennis. Is this for you? Are you Becky from Big Brother?
Oh, God.
I'm a super fan. What are you doing here?
I would have been like, no.
So just like late at night, rang the doorbell on a super fan's porch, just showed up with her mail and...
Oh, yeah. My, that would, and now they know, and now they have to know where you live.
No, they don't know. It's my sister's house.
Oh, it was your sister's house.
Yeah. Oh, my wow. Next door neighbors have already taken me to dinner with their friends so I can meet them.
Oh, well, that's fun. I think most fans are super nice. There are some that I would never give my address or anybody in my family's address to. But yeah, well, I'm glad that's hysterical. I like both of your stories.
We should start celebrity mail service. Like, how cool would it be if Matt Damon showed up with your mail?
Right.
That'd be cool.
Right. Okay. I will take a Matt Damon with the mail. I mean, didn't Taylor Swift start that trend with her little Swiftmas last year when she would like show up at fans' doorsteps with
Christmas packages?
Mm-hmm. For publicity. Yeah.
I was so excited about that. John, remember last night I was telling you how Taylor Swift would wrap the packages for Christmas and deliver them?
Right.
What's that?
Because she's a good person and not for publicity. Right.
I love her. When I grow up, I want to be Taylor Swift. So
I honestly love Taylor Swift too. Do you either of you watch Scream Queens on Fox? It's like a funny, kind of scary thing. Anyway, they did a spoof on the Taylor Swift thing on the show, but whatever. Island Girl 63 wants to know, have either of you watched the season back yet or any of the episodes back yet?
No, I haven't watched it yet. It's weird. I was such a big super fan coming into this. I was like, there's no way I'm not gonna watch it when I get off the show. It's just like, I haven't had time to. I have just enough time to watch Survivor and those 40 episodes. Like right now I just, there's no time for it. So eventually.
So you're not saying like, I don't want to, but you just don't have time.
No, it's not like I don't want to watch it. It's just like, I just haven't gotten around to it.
I don't think I'd watch it either if I lived it. Becky?
Yeah, I watched about 7 episodes in and I was just getting frustrated on how some things were cut. So I was like, no.
Got you. Do not blame me on all there. Maximus Mom wants to know, Johnny Mac, how are you liking Survivor since you are a Survivor fan? Who are you rooting for to win?
This season has been awesome. It's just like every tribal council, I'm not completely sure if it was like maybe, I don't know, 10 seasons ago, you were pretty confident by the end of the episode who was going to go home. It was just going to be like, oh, the one you're not expecting to go home. That's who it is. But now they've gotten better with it. Like with, I don't know, just tricking you into like thinking someone else is going to go home. And that, so I've been satisfied with the end of like every episode. And I'm Team Keith right now. I think Keith is he's good at not getting on people's radar. I don't know if he knows it, but he's good at just kind of going with the flow there. He almost won an immunity challenge and they still didn't get rid of him. So I think he's doing a good job.
Okay, Johnny Mac, we can't count the immunity challenge when it was him and one other person playing. That does not count as him almost winning an immunity challenge, Johnny Mac. By default, he almost won that before it even started.
He's there's second been a couple, place, no matter
there's
what.
There's been a couple that he's been in, though, right?
Well, I guess on his season, I think he won a bunch of them on.
I might have been thinking about the one with the ropes and the disc where the two balls were on it. Was he near the end of that one?
Yeah. I know he won one. I have a theory, and it is just my theory, but I won't say it if you don't want to know. It's how I feel like I can tell who is going to be voted off of Survivor. Like, when you say it is not predictable anymore, I feel like there is a very clear-cut strategy to the edit to figure it out. Do you want me to say it?
I don't want to ruin it.
Okay, and I don't know this for a fact. This is my theory. But watch it now going forward. I feel like the episode where you get a backstory or you learn a little bit more about somebody's personal life, the next episode, that's the one they go home. They don't send them home on the episode where you learn about them. They usually send them home on the next episode. And I feel that's holding true this season with the edit.
I'll have to watch out for that.
And it's also why I think Spencer's going to win, because everybody goes out of their way to be like, there's no way Spencer's going to win.
Yeah.
Spencer's not making it. And it doesn't even fit into the edit of the show. Like, people will be talking about Rice and they'll just cut to someone going, Spencer can't win this game. And I'm like, what? Does that mean he won the game? Do you watch Survivor, Becky, or no?
I study.
Right. That's right. You are.
Mind you, I lose my job if I don't pass this test.
That is true. We don't look. I have not
seen any TV in quite some time.
But you only have 1 month left, right?
Yeah.
1 month left. All right. And that's right. We're all doing.
I submerge. I come back out right in time for BB Canada.
Oh, perfect. Which, well, if you want, you let us know. No pressure, but we're covering BB Canada. We're doing exit interviews. Oh. So if you guys are watching, either of you, and you want to come on and talk Big Brother with us while it's on, you are more than welcome to come on.
Yes, that'll be more so the time that I'm ready to, like, come out and watch all this again.
Perfect. So then I guess this kind of answers the question that we didn't answer of, do you two have any meet and greets for fans planned?
I don't have any planned right now. Could happen in the future. I don't know. Nothing planned right now other than, I guess that reality that's happening next year. I'm going to go to that.
Are you both doing it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, high five. See you there.
Bam.
see you there. Maybe we'll pick you to be on our team. We get to pick who we want to be on our little race team.
I got picked today already. I just got an email. I didn't understand it, but I got picked.
I don't know if that's true. Jillian doesn't usually let people pick until like the week before because she lets media. I mean, I could be totally wrong. I have no idea about what's going on this year, but in previous years, you usually pick like the week or so before because she lets the media outlets pick who they want to race with first and way. But I'm sure if somebody raised, like, donated a ton of money and said, we want Becky.
That's what I got. Sure, I got the VIP one.
I'm sure you're going to go with those people that donated the most for you. It's a lot of fun.
Badass in competitions. They had to pick me.
You will. If you want to see what it's like, we did videos about it the last 2 years. You can watch us racing with Helen or Christine.
Helen, it would be a badass to race with. I love Helen.
Oh my God. Helen was like a drill sergeant with us. She was like, you're not going fast enough. We're like, oh my God, Helen, sorry, we're trying.
Love Helen.
Helen is the best. Okay, so no plans right now other than that. Well, there you go, guys. That's a great reason for you to head out to Reality Rally. And then I guess I will put the links below. So both of you have fundraising links for the Reality Rally. I'm assuming, right? Because if you're both doing it, then you have those links. I'll put them below this video on the edited video. If you guys this holiday season want to donate to Becky or Johnny Mac, the money is going to Michelle's place. That's a great thing you can do and help them raise their totals. The links will be below.
Yeah.
I love them. It's such a good chat. And if you guys have not done it before, get ready. Bring tissues.
There's I'm doing Toys for Tots next week. I still don't have all the details on it, but I don't know if there's like a meet and greet aspect to that.
I'm not sure.
If there is, then that's a thing, and I'll tweet that out as I find out about it this week. But I'm still getting the final details on that. So
perfect. I believe there is. I believe there is a meet and greet. BB Hyde wants to know from both of you, which house guest do you get asked about the most? Like, who do people want to know or hear on the most?
Yeah.
Okay, besides each other.
Yeah,
besides each other. After each other, who?
For me, it's probably Vanessa.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, me too.
They're just like, well, like, how did you... Like, what was it like being with her all the time? And they're like, what was she like? You know, that she's probably the most asked about one.
Same for you, Becky?
Absolutely. I try to get rid of her.
Okay, then, Johnny Mac, allow me to switch it up then and say the other most, the question I'm getting the most for you for this was, what is your relationship like with Steve now?
Yeah.
Steve and I were cool. We text every now and then. Actually, Monday, he's like driving through town he goes on a lot of adventures, it seems like. So he'll be in Scranton. So I made sure like I moved my lunch to the period he's going to be here. So we're going to get lunch on Monday.
Oh, that's right. I keep forgetting that you're in Pennsylvania.
Scranton, Pennsylvania.
Why did I think Scranton, New Jersey? There is a Scranton, New Jersey.
We're not in New Jersey. No,
you're not. You're in Pennsylvania. Okay, we're
little all... did you know, John, you live in New Jersey. Yes.
Don't you know where you live? I'm in New York. I thought Steve was close to me for some reason when we've been talking, and then he's like, I know. And I was like, Steve, you're like, he's like, let's do something. I'm like, you're 7 hours away. It's not happening. I'm on the Long Island.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, he's adorable. He bought a used car, which technically it's still 2015, but someone that wins $500,000 buys a used car. Steve's adorable.
He's smart.
He's smart.
He is.
Seriously, Becky.
He's financially savvy.
And you know, what is actually $500,000? Like 200 and something after?
Yeah, it's like $270,000. And he's going to invest. Like, Derek and him are being so smart with their money because you can invest it now, put it in something, let it grow, live off of interest and income later.
That is exactly what you should do. But yes. But that's why, look, if you two can get an amazing race, that's $1 million. Well, but it's going to be the same thing. But at least you're not splitting 500. You're splitting $1 million. So
yeah,
you're
come on, Jen.
Let's do it. Everybody. Tweet it out. I did see that you put it out there. Or Vanessa, if she wins one of these poker tournaments, she needs to hook you guys up. Hook us all up, Vanessa, if you're winning these millions in these tournaments.
Vanessa, pay my loans.
You should have got in on those conversations of let's all split the money five ways and just ride. I don't know. You didn't watch the show. I don't know if you were part of those conversations. I don't think
you're not allowed to split the money.
No, you're not. But Vanessa tried. I don't think you guys were part of the conversations. There was some talk.
Oh, hell no. I don't think she's splitting money with me.
Yeah, I don't think anybody would. I
Thanks
would
for
tell
getting
you
me out. Do you want to share $500,000?
Do it. Share it. I would tell you all. I'd be like, guys, let's share the money. That's good. Let's just all share the money. Let's do it in blood right now. And then you have to stick to it. And then I'd be like, nope.
It's that simple. I should have thought of that.
You should have thought of that. I don't know.
I'm so stupid.
Let's make a final 16.
Like Becky said, there's a lot of stuff when you watch the show back, the edit that's going to blow your mind. Which then again, Becky, going back to what I said in the beginning about talking to, you know, like talking to the fans on the feeds, the reason we appreciate it so much is
the edit sucks. Sorry.
Because you love that. They also cut the feeds on us, and it's a way for us to know, like, oh, what is really happening? Because even we all know the edit is completely not at all what's actually happening. So it's always great for us when we watch the feeds and you guys fill us in, like, this is what's really going on.
I think one of the big things, sorry to like cut in, I thought for the feeds that they'd be like able to watch conversations more. But what I wasn't thinking about was that, because I had so much game going on with Jackie from the beginning that I was talking to her about. However, we weren't one of like the main people. Even the feeds wouldn't come to us. Mm-hmm. Because, and like, that's something that I wasn't thinking. I was like, well, we're having the conversations. We're in the house. We're talking about game. They'll get it. And they didn't pick up on that. And so you're right. Like, looking back, talking to camera is a big thing, but I didn't realize how much the feeds would be on.
Personally, I feel the way you have to win Big Brother, and a lot of people don't like it, is you have to play the house, you have to play production, and you have to play America. Like, you have to play all three. And I think it makes for a really boring game, a la Derek, but it's why Derek, I think, is one of the best players, because
yes,
he hated Donnie in real life, which he talks about all the time now. But he was in that diary room like, oh, America, I love Donnie. Apple pie and ice cream. And I love him. I'm great. Because he knew America would not like it if he was in that diary room being like, I hate Donnie. He's the worst. So I think you got to play all three in a sense to, you know, win it. All right. We got to start wrapping this up and let you guys go back to your real lives. However, so many people love you. I can't, like, hundreds and hundreds of people in the chat room right now. Let's start with you, Becky. What is your Periscope?
Oh, yeah. My Periscope and all my handles are the same. It's Becky Burgess 17. So BECKYBURGESS. And that's Twitter, Periscope, Instagram, and at gmail.com. So
perfect. And all the links will be below this video. Johnny Mac, what about you?
The Twitter is at RockstarDMD. And then the YouTube channel is The Rockstar DMD. Mm-hmm. And Instagram is still Rockstar_Dennis, because some jerk has Rockstar DMD and they don't respond to it. Mm-hmm. Any messages I send them. So mm-hmm. I can't get it on there.
Well, the links will be below. Johnny Mac, a million, like, literally nonstop, I just have to tell you, aside from all the normal love that you're getting, people want you to know, most beautiful eyes, dimples, perfection, best smile, best laugh, totally cute, love Johnny Mac, he is the best. You have tons of that in the chat room.
Becky, thanks, guys.
Let's do a Johnny Mac calendar.
Oh, somebody.
That's a really good idea.
We got lots of talented people. Somebody do it and tweet them it. Make a Johnny Mac calendar. But Becky, I'm not leaving you out. People love you, say that you are beautiful, that you are such an inspiration to them, things that you've, you know, you've inspired them with your story. I know you've been putting more of it out on your Instagram about the accident and stuff like that. So people would just want you to know that you are a very inspiring person as well.
Wonderful.
They love you. Uh-oh. What happened? Now I don't hear you.
Me?
Oh, yep. Now you're back. Okay.
I know. My video looks slow, but I have full internet. Sorry.
Oh, no. You're good. I'm just trying to see if there's any. Okay. Final message to your fans. I'll start with you, Johnny Mac. What do you want to leave them with tonight?
Thanks for watching and being cool. And I hope you had an awesome holiday, because I did. I hope it was good for you too.
And they love it. Becky, what do you want to leave them with?
something very similar. I'm glad everyone had a great holiday, and thanks for following us when we're not just on a crazy show, but when we're just being us in the day. That's when you get to know us best. It's not in the Big Brother house. It's every day.
It is real life. Well, on behalf of all of your fans, they all love you. I will tell people, come back during the week. Mondays, we do Bravo. Tuesdays, Scream Queens. Wednesdays, Survivor. Thursdays is usually our Big Brother show. And Fridays is our fan show. And I think next Thursday is going to be your guys' favorite, the twins. And
yay!
Austin.
Yeah.
So tune in for that. And yeah, thank you guys so much for taking time to talk to your fans. They loved you. Literally over, looking like 2,000 people viewing, 2,300. So you have fans that love you guys so much.
Aww.
Yay, thank you.
Thanks for coming out.
Thanks for coming out. Make sure you follow them on Twitter. Follow us on Twitter. We will see you guys all later. Say goodbye to everybody in the chat room.
Bye, everyone.
Later.
Bye, guys.